Hi there, my name's Andy James and welcome to another Licklibrary web lesson. I'm going to be doing a series of web lessons on alternate picking, and in this first lesson we're going to be looking at the very basics that make up the technique of alternate picking. So without further ado, let's get and look at the first example and delve into the technique of alternate picking. Okay, in this first example, basically we're just going to be looking at playing one string and one fret. What the idea of this is just to get used to the kind of down up motion with your right hand for alternate picking. Now, you could argue the fact that this is kind of tremolo picking, but as we progress we'll be adding more notes, so it will become less tremolo picking and more alternate picking, but it's just to get used to the action. A couple of things that's worth bearing in mind with alternate picking as well is, the picks that I use, a lot of rock guitar players that play metal or rock or anything to do with kind of the shred genre tend to use kind of really stiff, really hard picks. Big stubbies spring to mind. Tony McAlpine is quite well known for using big stubbies, and a lot of people use them for bass as well, but they've got a really sort of fine point on them. The same with jazz threes. John Petrucci from Dream Theater uses jazz threes, the smaller ones, and they're really tiny, but they're really good for accurate playing if you're kind of used to that. Me personally, I'm quite a heavy picker, so I've kind of found that heavy picks don't really add consistency to my picking. But I found that I've got these Dunlop USA 0.71mm picks that have just got about enough flex in it so you can really push through the string. And for me personally, it gives me more consistency with my alternate picking. It allows me to kind of nail everything, so I'm pretty much on it. It's worth trying out different picks and see what feels best. Also, the only other thing that I will suggest is flat picking for fast picking, as far as I'm concerned, kind of isn't really the best way of doing it, which means that your pick is literally flat against the string, so you'll just be... Basically, it gets caught up, and sometimes you can kind of miss notes out and it'll sound a little messy. A lot of players, what they tend to do is they kind of angle the pick forward slightly. The reason for this is because the edge of the pick just slides off the string a little easier, and it allows you to get a bit more flow between the strings. Michelangelo is quite well known for his kind of odd technique where he actually gets the pick like that and he picks up and down. So he uses the pick sort of like vertically like that. So he's just kind of picking the strings in a very kind of odd manner. It'd be the same as if you were doing a downward pick, but he just does it up. Sean Lane, again, he was another amazing alternate picker. He had the same kind of technique where he would have the pick at that kind of angle and he kind of almost snapped through the strings. He had a really cool style of alternate picking. Anyway, that's enough of me going on. We'll look at the first technique and then I'll just explain a bit about how I've done it. Okay, during that example, I started off pretty slow, using my first finger on the 9th fret on the G string, and just holding that down. So we're really not concentrating on what the left hand's doing at the moment, it's just literally getting to grips with the down, up, down.